Hello everyone! Welcome back to our Math Ocho YouTube channel. At kung di ka pa nakakapag-subscribe, aba, mag-subscribe na para updated kayo sa ating weekly lesson. And for today's video, we're going to have our lesson for third quarter, week 1 and week number 2, which is all about mathematical system. Are you ready to learn? Alright! Let's go! The wonders of geometry are present everywhere, in nature and in structures. Take a look at the different pictures. Okay, the first one is a bridge. So, kung mapapansin nyo, ito ay medyo luma na, no? But in this picture, you can visualize again geometrical figures. Another one is a tower. In this picture also, in a tower, you can visualize different geometrical shapes, especially triangles. In the buildings, houses, vehicles. In nature and even in outer space, all of those pictures that you saw has a common, and that is the wonders of geometry. They have different geometrical figures, and that is all about the mathematical system. And to start the lesson for today, let us have our objectives. At the end of the lesson, the learners are expected to describe a point, line, and plane. Define line segment, ray, angle, collinear points, non-collinear points, coplanar points, non-coplanar points. And illustrate corresponding postulates or theorems based on specific figures and vice versa. Mathematical system is what we call geometry. And we have four classifications of mathematical system. We have undefined terms, defined terms, postulate, and theorem. Again, the four classifications of mathematical system: undefined terms, defined terms, postulate, and theorems. Let us talk about the undefined terms. Undefined terms are starting point of mathematical system that used to define, explains other terms or concept in the system. What are the three undefined terms in geometry or in mathematical system? The three undefined terms are, we have point, line, and plane. Again, the three undefined terms in a mathematical system, point, line, and plane. Let's talk about point. A point, in Tagalog, tuldo. A point in geometry is a location. It has no size, walang laki, no width, no length, walang haba, no depth, lalim. It is shown by a dot, no? That is tuldo. It is named using an uppercase letter. So kapag tayo nagpapangalan ng point, ginagamit natin ay yung malalaking letra. Pwedeng from A to Z, no? Example, so we have here, yes, that is a dot, no, the point, and we have here letter, ayan, we have here this point, and then uppercase letter D, so this is point D, alright? And an example of a point is a tip of a ball pen, no, yung dulo ng inyong ball pen. Kung may ball pen kayo, yung dulo nun, That is an example of a point. Corner of a box. So yung box, yung pinakang corner nun, representation pa rin yun ng point. The stars in the sky, that is also a point. No, yung mga pimples nyo sa mukha or yung taling nyo, yun ay mga example ng point. Okay? So guys, that is a point. Again, a point in geometry is a location. Walang laki, walang lapad, walang haba, walang lalim. It is shown by a dot. The second undefined term is what we call line. So what is a line? A line consists of infinitely many points and extends infinitely in opposite direction. So ang line daw ay binubuo ng napakaraming dikit-dikit na tuldok na naka-extend in opposite direction. It is named using two points. So pinapangalanan natin ang line gamit ang dalawang tuldok na nasa line mismo. Example, ayan. So take a look at this line. No? Itong line na to is a two-headed arrow. Represented yan ng ating line. So bakit two-headed arrow? Kasi nga sabi doon sa ating definition, extend infinitely in opposite direction. Ibig sabihin niyan, kaya yan ay naka-arrow papunta doon sa right at papunta sa left kasi nag-e-extend pa yan, tuloy-tuloy pa yan. Okay. So we have here point K and we have point L. So this can be read as line KL, no? Or we can use a small letter. So pwede rin siyang tawaging line N. Na small letter or dalawang tuldok na capital letters or uppercase letter. So that is how we named a line. So we can name this line as line KL or line N. Okay, an example of a line, edge of a book. Na yung book nyo yung gilid. So representation siya ng line. The stretch rope, na tali, strand of hair, wires, no? Yung mga wires na yan, that those are example of line, right? The third undefined term is a plane. This is not airplane, plane. So ano ba ang plane? Plane is a flat surface which extends infinitely in all direction. Ito naman ay flat surface. O, diba? Pag nakakita na kayo ng surface, representation na siya ng plane. So it is named by three points in the plane. So kung kanina yung ating dot ay one letter, yun namang ating line ay two points on the line. Ito namang plane can be named using three points in the plane, nasa plane, that are not on the same line. So let us have an example. Okay, so we have here a plane. Ito, this is a plane. No, it is a flat surface. Then we have here three points on the plane. Points A, B, and C. So this can be named as plane ABC. Or by using a small letter, no, or lowercase letter. So this can be named also as plane M. Alright, so this is a plane. So what are the example of a plane? Example of planes are surface of a table, no, yung table, and then yung inyong wall, no, sheet of paper, the ceilings, no, the basketball court. So those are example of a plane. Alright, so again guys, what are the three undefined terms? So we have a point, line, and plane. Now let's talk about the second classification of mathematical system, and that is the defined terms. So defined terms are terms explained using undefined terms. Diba? Ayan, the first one is the line segment, followed by array, angle, collinear points. So we have line segment, ray, angle, collinear points, non-collinear points, coplanar points, and non-coplanar points. So you can take a screenshot of this slide, no, the defined terms, para pag-move natin sa next slide, explanation na lang tayo. Okay, so let us have the explanation for the first defined terms, which is a line segment. So a line segment is a part of a line, or ang tawag natin dyan is subset of a line. So bahagi lang siya ng line. Yung kaninang line natin na two-headed arrow, kukuha lang tayo ng part doon, yun yung tatawagin nating line segment, no? That has two end points whose length is fixed. Okay? Hindi siya nag-extend kasi nga ang length ng line segment ay fixed. So let us have here an example. Ayan. So suppose if this is a line, no, two-headed arrow siya. So in this figure, nawala na yung two-headed arrow. Ang end natin dito ay mga points na lang, which is point A and point B. Meaning hindi na siya mag-extend. Ito na yung fixed niyang length, no? So ang tawag niya diyan ay line segment. And how do we name a line segment? So we named a line segment using the two endpoints, and that is point A and point B. So we can name this one as line segment AB or segment AB. So that is a line segment. Again, a line segment has two endpoints. It is not extended. Hindi na siya, no? May fixed length ang ating line segment. So how do we name? Using again the two endpoints, the two letters, the endpoints, and that is line segment AB. Okay, is line segment clear? Again, you can take a screenshot of this slide. Then we are going to move on to the next defined term. Okay, so the next defined term is array. Now, array. Array is a part of a line. So para rin siyang line segment, no? Subset of a line pa rin. Bahagi lang siya ng line, which extends in only one direction indefinitely. So ibig sabihin nag-extend siya sa isa lang direction. So let us have a figure. Okay, take a look at this one. Okay, so we have here one-headed arrow going to this side, na ito yung arrow natin. So kung mapapansin nyo, yung one point niya or one end is an endpoint, and the other one is an arrow. So this is an example, or this is the figure that represents array. Array has one endpoint and extend in one direction. Kaya isang arrow lang yung makikita nyo. So saan siya mag-extend? From point A going to point B, extended on this side. Tuloy-tuloy yan, ibig sabihin yan, no? And how do we name array? So we named array using the two points on the array, no? The endpoint and the other points. So we have here array AB. Array AB. The symbol for array, so we have here, yan, array, and then we have here A and then B. Ayan. So that is how we write array AB. Next, angle. So an angle is a union of two rays, o dalawang ray na siya, with a common endpoint. That is called a vertex. So I think na-encounter nyo na to nung grade 7 kayo, ang angle. So let us have here an example. Ayan. Okay. So in this case, ayan, we have here angle DAC. So the first ray is ray AD from this point A going to point D. So isang ray yon. The other ray is from point A going to point C, another ray yon. Kaya ang sabi natin sa angle is a union of two rays. So dalawang ray with a common endpoint. So ano yung endpoint na yon? That is point A. Dito sila. Ito yung common sa kanila. Ang tawag dyan is the vertex. Okay? So how do we name the angle? Using the three letters. And remember, the middle letter is always the vertex. So this is angle DAC. Ayan, ang symbol natin sa angle. Now this one is the symbol for angle. Okay? So, that is an angle. Next, collinear points. Ayan, co and then linear. So, what does it mean? These are points that all lie on the same line. Ayan, ito daw yung mga points na nasa isang linya lang. Let us have a figure. So, ayan, we have here a line and then we have point A, point B, and point C. So, those three points are lying in one line. Therefore, we can say that points A, B, and C are called collinear points. Again, when we say collinear, these are points lying on the same line. Ko, ibig sabihin ko, kasama sa iisang linya. So, yun yung mga points na nasa iisang linya, collinear. Okay? Next one. The next one is non-collinear points. So, when we say non-collinear points, these are points that are not on the same line. So, ninegate na natin yung kanina na collinear, eto, nilagyan natin ng non, it means that not, no? So, they are not lying on the same line. So, let us have an example. Okay, so let's say we have here, ayan, three points. Point D, E, and F. Suppose this point D is on this line. Ayan, nag-draw tayo ng line. And this point E, eto naman, nandyan yan sa line na yan. Ayan, magkaibang line. And this point F, ayan, suppose line yan. Medyo nabakilot lang yung pagdodraw ko. Okay, so this is this point D, point E, and point F are non-collinear points. Why? Because they are not lying on the same line. Nasa magkakaibang linya sila. No? Hindi sila magkakasama sa iisang linya. Kaya ang tawag dyan sa tatlong points na yan ay non-collinear points. Okay? I hope it is clear for you, non-collinear points. The next one, coplanar points. Again, we have here the word co and then planar. Co, magkasama, planar is plane. So, it means points belonging to the same plane. Ito daw yung mga points na nasa isang plane. So, let us have here an example. Ayan. Okay. So, we have here points A, B, C, and D. And they are lying in one plane. Ito yung ating plane, no? At nasa loob yan ng isang plane. Therefore, we can say that points A, B, C, and D are coplanar points. Why? Because they are lying in one plane. Okay? So, para yan yung halimbawa, mga players sa basketball court, yung 10 naglalaro, nasa isang court, ayan, mga coplanar points yung mga player na yon kasi nasa isang court lang sila. No? Next, non-coplanar points. Ayan, we attach here again this word, non, and then coplanar points. So, based on this word, we have do not lie in the same plane. So, wala naman yan sa isang plane. No? So, let's have an example. Ayan. Okay, take a look at this one. In this figure, we have two different planes. Etong plane na to, ayan, at may hati sa gitna, ito yung pangalawang plane. So, magkaiba na yan, no? So, in this case, we can say that points A, B, C, and D are non-coplanar points. Non-coplanar sila kasi nasa magkaibang plane sila, no? Hindi sila magkakasama sa iisang plane. So, that is non-coplanar points. Okay, I hope that is very clear to you. Okay, now let's move on to the third classification of mathematical system, and that is what we call postulate. So, this definition of postulate, you already encountered the word postulate in our second quarter, no? Nung ang topic natin ay proof, no? May mga postulate na tayo na-encounter doon. So, what is postulate? Postulate is a statement that is assumed to be true and accepted even without proof. So ito yung mga statement natin na hindi na dumaan sa process ng pagpapatunay kasi nga they are accepted without a proof. Yun yung postulate na tinatawag na. So we have some examples of postulate no nung sa ibang books ang tawag dito line postulate no. Two distinct points determine a line. Basta daw may dalawa tayong tuldok na magkaiba, then if you connect that no, that two distinct points always determine a line. So that is a line postulate. So another one, this postulate, if two planes intersect, then their intersection is a line. So kung meron kang halimbawang papel, dalawang papel, tapos yung isang papel i-intersect mo dun sa other one, no? Magka-create siya ng line dun sa gitna ng isa. Pag binutasan mo 'yon, so tinanggal mo yung intersection na 'yon, that is a line, no? So those are example of postulate, and we have different postulate that we may encounter in this third quarter. No? Marami tayong mga postulate, especially in geometry. Marami tayong may encounter ng mga postulate. Okay? The fourth classification of mathematical system is a theorem. So, what is a theorem? A theorem is a statement that follows logically from previous definitions and principles, a statement that can be proved to be true. So, yung mga theorems naman, ito yung mga statements na kailangan muna natin na i-prove na totoo, no? Gamit yung mga definitions, mga principles, mga properties, and mga theorems bago natin siya magamit, no? But here in this case, yung mga ituturo natin sa inyo ay na-prove na yan ng mga great mathematicians. That's why ini-apply na natin siya, no? So we have here some theorems, no? If two angles form a linear pair, then they are supplementary, no? Supplement theorem. And then other one, if two angles are vertical angles, then they have equal measures. So this is vertical angle theorem. So again, marami pa tayong may encounter na mga theorems as we go along to our third quarter, especially pagdating natin sa proving triangle congruence. So marami pa yan at marami pa kayong matutunang mga theorems this third quarter. Okay? So those are the four classifications of mathematical system. Diyan umiikot ang mundo ng geometry sa apat na yan. So again, what are those? Recall muna tayo bago tayo pumunta sa next slide. So the four classifications of mathematical system, we have undefined terms, defined terms, postulate, and theorems. Okay. Ayan, so for your learning task number 1. So para sa mga makakapanood dito, ayan ang gagawin yung learning task no, na ipapasa again during retrieval. So for your learning task number 1, determine the undefined terms suggested by the following. So ang isasagot nyo lang dyan ay yung undefined terms at tatlo lang yun, di ba? The points, line, and plane. So, may example na tayo rito. Number 1, screen of an iPad. Is it a point, a line, or a plane? So, the answer is a plane. Yung screen ng iPad, di ba? Flat surface yun. So, representation siya ng plane. Next, number 2, stretch wire of a phone charger. O, yung wire ng mga charger, anong nare-represent nun? Is it a point, line, or a plane? Yes, that is a line. O, ganun lang. Ang gagawin nyo sa numbers 3 to 10, identify nyo lang kung anong undefined term yan, kung point, line, or plane. Mole on the human body, yan, mga taling, tip of a crayon, wall of a room, intersection of two strings, edge of a bond paper, a whiteboard, intersection of a ceiling and wall, and a strand of hair. So, write your answer on your paper. And again, do not forget to write the week number, the learning task. Siyempre, yung section nyo, tsaka yung name nyo. Kasi nahihirapan kaming maghanap kung anong week number yung checka namin. Okay? So, this is for week number 1. Mathematical system is the lesson. Okay, next, learning task number 2. Ayan, illustrate the following. So, kanina may example tayo dun sa taas ng mga line segment, ray, no angle. So, how are you going to illustrate? Ido-drawing nyo siya dito, no? Line segment MN, mo paano niya ido-drawing yan dito sa space na to? Ray XY, okay? So, hindi ko na siya pwedeng i-drawing kasi may example naman tayo rito. Balikan nyo na lang yung video kung paano i-drawing yung mga yan. Illustrate, no? Ray YX. Oh, di ba? Anong difference ni Ray XY sa Ray YX? The angle ABC and angle K. So, illustrate nyo lang. Ido-drawing nyo lang. Napakadali yan. Next, for learning task number 3. Using the given figure at the right. Ayan. Identify whether the following points are collinear points or non-collinear. So, dito sa numbers 1, 2, 3, ito lang isasagot nyo, is it collinear or non-collinear? So, paano nga malalaman kung collinear points? They are lying in one line or the same line. Paano naman ang non-collinear? They are not lying on the same line. So, number 1, point B, ito si B. Ito si D, si A. Nasa isang linya ba yan? O, sagutan nyo na. Points C, F, and E. C, ito naman yung F, lumayo. Ito naman yung E. O, diba? Magkakalayo sila. And number 3, points B, A, and E. O, magkakalayo rin yan. So, go. Sagutan na. Next. 4 and 5, ang isasagot nyo naman is coplanar or non-coplanar points. Again, pag coplanar, nasa isang plane, non-coplanar points, nasa magkahiwalay na plane. So, check natin yung points sa number 4. C, D, B. So, this is point C. Ito naman ang D. Ito naman ang B. O, nasa isang plane ba yan? O, diba? Medyo tricky yung ating figure. Pero, kung nabivisualize nyo, aba, masasagutan nyo yan. Next, number 5, points E, F, and G. Ito si E, tumaas naman yung F, at bumaba naman yung G. Tanong, nasa iisang plane ba yan? Okay, so if you know the answer, write your answer on a sheet of paper. Okay, next task, learning task number 4. Draw the following postulates and theorems based on the given condition. So, we have here 5 different condition, then you are just going to draw here based on the condition. Number 1, okay, na-explain ko kanina to, siguro makukuha nyo sagot if you are going to go back to the video. 2 distinct points determine a line. O, dalawang tuldok na magkaiba, and then you draw a line. Next, if line M contains 2 points, no, C and D, then CD is equal to DC. Ayan. So, you draw line M and then lagay niyo yung points na C at D. O, yun lang yun. Next, number 3. If point D lies in the interior of angle ABC, ayan, you have angle ABC, mag-draw kayo dito ng angle ABC at ilagay niyo yung point D sa loob ng ABC, then you draw a ray. Ayan. Next, number 4, if line AB and CD intersect at point F, or may dalawa kang line, yung AB, mag-draw ka dyan ng line AB, tapos ng CD, tapos intersect mo sa point F, and then, ayun na. And finally, number 5, if a point lies outside a line, ayan, so may line ka, and then may point na nasa labas ng line, then exactly one plane contains both the line and the point. O, yun lang. Very basic yung ating mga situation and conditions. You are just going to draw on this side. Okay? And for learning task number 5, write if the statement is a postulate or a theorem. So, ang isasagot ko lang dyan, postulate ba yan or theorem? So, number 1, if point D lies in the interior of angle ABC, Then measure of angle ABD plus measure of angle CBD is equal to measure of angle ABC. Is it a postulate or a theorem? Any two right angles are congruent. So, kailangan pa bang i-prove yan? O hindi na, di ba? So, dun pala sa statement, ma-identify mo na. Next, number 3. If two points lie in a plane, then the lines joining them lies in the plane. Number 4. If two angles are vertical, then they are congruent. And number 5. In a right angle triangle, the square of the hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the square of the other two sides. Nako, si Pythagorean yan. Number 5. Doon pa lang sa name na binanggit ko, ma-identify nyo na kung siya ay postulate or theorem sa number 5. Okay? And you can watch our Math 8 online turuan on Thursday, and we are going to explain these different postulates and theorems para may maisagot kayo rito sa learning task number 5. Okay. For your performance task, you're going to illustrate the following definitions or postulate or theorem. Na i-illustrate nyo, ibig sabihin, i-draw nyo siya na, sa papel. Number 1, vertical angle theorem. Naku, napakadali niyan. Number 2, linear pair theorem. Definition of midpoint. Intersecting lines and intersecting planes. Again, i-draw niyan, 2 points each. Alright, so before we end this lesson, again, we are inviting the grade 8 of Binyan Integrated National High School. Watch every Thursday, 1 to 2 p.m. No, sa ating Grado 8 Ganado FB page. Doon, magkakaroon tayo doon ng Math 8 online turuan wherein i-discuss natin ng buo para tayo nasa loob ng classroom. Kung magbibigay kami ron ng mga examples and explanation, clear explanation of the lesson. And doon na rin natin mismo sasagutan yung mga learning task. Doon na rin tayo mag-check ng mga task. At pagka-check natin na inyong mga learning task, wala na kayong gagawin. Okay, so I hope you learned and understand our lesson for week 1 and week 2. So hanggang next week pa yan. No, 2 weeks ang coverage nito, kaya medyo marami-rami tayong learning task. No, and thank you and God bless everyone. Happy learnings!